It's time for our weekly political panel with Nationals Paula Bennett and New Zealand First Shane Jones. Paula's with us here in the Auckland studio, and Shane is beaming in from Kerikeri. Morena to you both.
Good morning.
Shane, you're all good?
Yep, loud and clear, buddy.
Nice, love it. Hey, Paula, we'll start with you. It's rude not to. You're sitting right next to me. Trans-Tasman bubble. Where do you stand?
Let's go. Let's bring in the Pacific. Let's bring in Australia. Let's open that up. Let's do it carefully. You know, let's make sure that we've got some testing going on and we're opening those borders. But, you know, we need it. They need it. We want to see these businesses thriving, and we need some people coming on in. So I just think it can be done sensibly.
I mean, we're good. Are you confident that they've got themselves sorted as well?
Yeah, well, I think there's some really clever ways that we can kind of make sure that we are doing some testing and absolutely checking that. And, you know, you just need to talk to those technical experts and see it. So, you know, I am full of confidence, and I think it's only going to improve as we sort of go ahead. But I also cry out for the Pacific. You know, they're our whānau, they're our family, and we should be looking after them as well. And I'm sure that there's some New Zealanders that would like a bit of sunshine this winter.
Shane, get it open.
Yeah, no, I'm willing to demonstrate my purchasing power by buying the first ticket to go to the Cook Islands with my wife. But in terms of the Australasian bubble, that's 30 million people when you add their population to our population. As you know, my rangatira Winston, no one has pushed it more vigorously than him. But we always had to prepare for this time when, I mean, we just cannot remain hermetically sealed and actually look after ourselves. So at some point in time, we're going to have to manage the risk, and why not do it Trans-Tasman-wise? And it'll enable me to bring back my granddaughter.
I could do a whip around, Shane, and you could stay in the Cook Islands for 100 days.
I'm in a kind of diplomatic mood this morning, so I won't give a riposte to that unwanted remark.
What about the concerns, though? We spoke to Dilipa Fonseca from Newsroom, who said there is a real concern about a brain drain. You know, people buggering off across the Tasman because, especially in the construction sector, things are tough here. Jobs are over there. They pay more. Is that a concern?
Oh, I mean, absolutely. But we're New Zealand. We don't close the borders so that people don't leave. You know, so I understand that completely. And that's where getting our own businesses and giving them confidence, actually acknowledging that it is business that needs support right now, and not just through the wage subsidy, but actually helping them get back on their feet. So, look, I'm sure that there's some that might choose that lifestyle. They have, you know, in all the decades I've been around. But we can't close the borders so that people don't leave. You know, we're not one of those countries.
Are you concerned about a brain drain, Shane?
Well, I won't recite Muldoon's famous saying, but the reality is in the early 90s, a lot of our relations, communities from the far north, they all relocated to Australia. We've got to ensure that if we say we're going to kick off infrastructure projects, that we get cracking. And this is really for all of the parties in Parliament. Strip away the unnecessary obstacles. And if people do go over there, I suspect people will come this way as well, because it remains a fantastic place to raise your family and your kids.
This is so nice. Should I build a little bonfire so that you two can sing Kumbaya around it together or something?
Wow, there's a lot of things we do have in common, and that's certainly supporting New Zealand and New Zealanders.
But, Shane, I wanted to get to you because over the last couple of days you've been claiming that Nationals about to launch a dirty politics campaign up in the far north to get your seat.
Oh, no, I bumped into Matt King the other day, where I described him as the King of Spades and Matua Shane as the King of Hearts. But he said to me, I give you my word, there's no dirty tricks campaign. My remarks really were related to what's happening with a small piece of legislation I'm shepherding through Parliament, where the foreign owners of the forestry sector have been selling their and peddling their mistruths to some of the backbenchers in the National Party. So I put down fair warning. I'm a pugilist from the Bible. Do unto others as they'll do unto you.
Oh, look, there's no way. There's not a dirty campaign. I think Shane's trying to get a bit ahead of some of the stuff that might be going on. But at the end of the day, we just want to run a straight campaign up there. And Matt King is absolutely awesome. He gets around, he understands that community, he fights for it. So I'm backing him on his own merits. And I think... How many times have you had a go, Shane? Five? Is this number five?
I'll tell you what, though, It's the New Zealand First Party that decided not to choose Paula and Bill English and chose Jacinda and made her the Prime Minister. It's the New Zealand First Party that's at the centre of the architecture. Don't worry about that, Paula.
Oh, well, you've just blown the bonfire kumbaya, Shane. I mean, you just sort of hit that one in. So that's a bit, you know.
And here I was hoping you two were going to be the bridge over troubled waters together. Yeah. That's not going to be the case.
Oh, look, as I say, we've got 100 days now until the election, mm-hmm. which isn't much at all. So, yeah, everyone's going to be putting their best foot forward and their best ideas, I hope, and we get to really sort of discuss the economy and what's going to be happening and bring it on, eh?
Yeah, no, it's at one level quite a surprise. Where has the guts of 3 years gone? But, look, I'm looking forward, along with my other parliamentary colleagues, to a vigorous and tough contest, and we'll get out there and put our options before the people and do it in such a way that we don't smear or taint the value of a democratic campaign in the far north.
I'm not sure a holiday in the Cook Islands is kind of in with working hard in that campaign period, but you go for it.
Hey, I just wanted to quickly ask as well, we had is she your boss, Nikki Kaye? Is she your boss now?
Oh, that's another level, isn't it? I'm not easy to boss around.
No, I bet you're not.
No.
She gave Nationals' performance at the moment a 7.5.
Oh,
is that
good
a fair assessment?
Look, there's a lot of hard work going on, and I know that they are, and they're just getting stuck in, and there's so much of the policy work to sort of do post-COVID and what that looks like. So I definitely give them a 7.5 for how hard they're working and what they're doing.
What do you reckon, Shane? Fair enough, 7.5?
Oh, look, I don't want to make the mistake of Paul Goldsmith and talk about crocheting or knitting. Just whoever the leaders are, get on and do the mahi. Harvest the votes where you can find them, because I know what we're going to do, which is fill up the kete of votes and win the seat of Northland.
Love it. Bring it on.
Yeah, bring on the next 100 days, exactly. And let's see where it lands.
Hey, thank you so much. That's Paula Bennett and Shane Jones.